Rev up your engines!
Well, here we go again with Kia garbage quality. A customer of mine just got a recall notice for his 2021 Kia Soul. They're recalling them, of course, to check them out, right? The engine might blow up. Turns out they didn't make the piston rings right. You get oil consumption, can lead to connecting rod failure, the engine can blow up. Here we go again. A while back, the older ones had problems. Ones they were making in the United States, they said, oh, well, this one machine isn't good and it made them wrong and the engines could blow up, right? Well, here they are again. Did they learn anything? No, they learned nothing. Now, if you own one, the NHTSA recall number is 21V259 is the recall number. They always telling you, oh, they're better made now. No, they aren't. They had engine problems years ago. They had to recall and replace engines. And I had customers that had the engines fixed or replaced only to find later they broke again. No, you don't buy the stuff if you want quality. It's going to last a long time. His is a 2021 and it's already being recalled for bad piston rings. Their quality is just... They can talk all they want about, oh, we're a big brand, we're expanding sales, blah, blah, blah. They still don't make quality products. There's my customer, got a recall notice for a 2021 Kia Soul that the engine might explode because the piston rings weren't built correctly. They call it a potential fire hazard. Fire hazard, the engine might blow up. It's not really a fire hazard, it's just a stupid thing. It's not going to run anymore. They just don't have the quality. They can BS all they want with advertising firms about how great they are. They're still making garbage. A 2021 Kia Soul, and the engine could blow up because they didn't make the piston rings right. They're making piston rings for 150 years or more. You think they'd have it down pat by now. Kevin says, Scott, I got 2012 Infiniti G37S manual. For the last 50,000 miles, six gear buzzes with my foot in the accelerator and drives. The dealership can't figure it out. Any ideas? Put it in fifth gear. It doesn't buzz. Put it in sixth gear, it buzzes. Your sixth gear is starting to wear out. They just don't want to tell you that. If there's any warranty on it, they don't want to have to tear the whole transmission apart and rebuild six gear. That's a gigantic job. You have to split the case, take it all apart. I don't even know anybody that does that kind of work on those things anymore, on those Japanese standard transmissions. I truthfully don't even know anybody who does it. So if it only does it in six, it's got to be six gears worn and it's buzzing because it's worn inside. My advice is don't use six gear, keep it in fifth. Now let's say it doesn't buzz when you're just going at a steady speed, go ahead and cruise in six, but don't accelerate hard in it because eventually the buzzing will make something break off, and then when it does, goodbye transmission. Infiniti's always had weak transmissions. Big engines fast, but the transmission's kind of weak. Carl Emil Sunderland said, how do I fix a deep scratch on chrome plastic? Okay. The problem is, it is plastic. Now, they chrome plate plastic. Yes, they do. Well, there's really not much you can do because, you know, you can get paint. They make a chrome in quotation mark paints, but it doesn't shine and look like regular chrome, you know? If you really wanted to try, you could get a little Bondo, fill the hole in, buff it off, and get some of that little chrome paint and try to cover up that one little part, but really, it's plastic. Buy another piece of plastic if it really bothers you. Especially, let's say you see one in a junkyard, they'll sell it to you cheap enough. The new stuff might cost a fortune at a dealer, but if there's some in a junkyard, do like I do. If somebody scratches something on my old Matrix, I go to a junkyard, get one that's in there, polish it up, see if it looks good, then I buy it if it polishes up. You don't always have to buy stuff at a dealer and pay outrageous prices. Durbin Mervin says, bought a 99 4Runner, bad fuel smell. Drove it home and popped the code, EVAP fault. Any ideas? Okay. That means you got a problem in the EVAP system. First thing, and this could easily fix it, the simplest thing on earth, buy a gas cap. If it doesn't seal, you're gonna smell gas. Now, if it isn't, what generally goes bad on those is the EVAP canister vent valve sticks open. So you would probably need a new EVAP canister vent valve. But on those, a lot of times it's just the cap or go under the hood. And if some idiot changed the air filter on that car, there's EVAP lines that plug on there. A lot of times they do that, they put the air filter back on, snap the top, and that plastic rubber line and hose comes off and you'll smell it then. If you look under, you might see one of those hoses just came off and snap it back on. That's the easiest fix on earth. And it happens all the time when people change the air filter if they're not careful. Mike Earl says, if you have an all-wheel drive system like the rear wheels are controlled by an electric motor like the Toyota RAV4, do you still have to replace all four tires when getting a flat? Well, in that particular case, no. You would just have to change both front ones or both back ones because your back tires are their own separate system run only electronically. They don't care what the front ones are doing. And so it won't start adjusting things because the front tire is different than the back. It only affects the back tires. So as long as they're both exactly the same, if you got a flat on one side, you'd have to replace both tires in the back. And you'd have to change the tires in the front in pairs, but you wouldn't have to change all four then because that is a unique system that only drives off electricity in the back. And the slip and everything that goes in that only affects the electric motor computer system, not the rest. It says, Shell gasoline. I know Shell Premium is good gas with a V-Power. My question is, how is a regular 87 octane gas? Is it just as good? Well, Shell, I believe, even today, is the number one refiner of crude oil to make gasoline in the world. They don't get it all, but other companies use them to refine oil into gasoline. Of course, their regular gasoline, it's perfectly fine. It's lower octane. Most cars run perfectly fine on lower octane gasoline, and there's nothing wrong with it at all. Actually, if you got like a Toyota Corolla and it's made to run on regular gas, if you put premium, will actually run worse on the premium because it's not made for running on that type of gasoline. So if you got an engine that's set up for the low octane that's easier to ignite and you put high octane, it may not even run as well. So don't waste your money. They're all, you know, the grades are exactly what they say. Regular, medium, and high test, they're just different octane ratings. Sometimes they put a little bit more cleaner in the high tech ones, but I mean, mainly it's just the octane rating and the things. If you don't need it, don't waste your money. Jonathan 32 says, I got an 011 Subaru Forester. My original MAF sensor went bad. I bought a new one, but now the engine light came on. Tell me the new sensor's faulty. What could be causing this? First of all, if you're going to change a MAF sensor, only use an OEM one. Don't go to a discount auto parts store and buy one of those Chinese-made pieces of crap. It's a very specific piece of computer software operates that thing. And if it's not perfect, it will do that. So if you didn't buy the OEM, go get an OEM one. I know they cost more. And if you want to be cheap, go to a junkyard. Try a used one. They usually last quite some time. But if it still comes on, then you either got a wiring problem or you got a problem in your computer driver circuits to drive. Now, knowing Subarus, they're made pretty well, you know, 2011. I'm assuming it's just the sensor and you got one of these junky Chinese ones that doesn't work. That's why you don't want to put cheap electronic parts on your car, because if it doesn't fix, you said it must be something else. No. I've even had that happen to me in the past. That's why I only use the OEM ones. And I tell customers, if they want to save money and they want to buy one of these things, look, I'll tell them, here's how it puts it on. Do it yourself. It just pops in and out. Do it yourself. But if it doesn't work, don't whine at me. I told you how to put it in. If you got a cheap one, you get one that's $89 and the dealer one is $350, there's a big quality difference between that. Sometimes if you want to try used, maybe you could gamble with that, but I would never use the Chinese-made ones. They're garbage. They don't hold up. Sometimes they don't even work as soon as you plug them in. Well, finally, a used car dealer sleaze bag. One of them sent to jail. There's a guy by the name of Shmuel Ghali in federal court in Brooklyn. They got him for buying cars, tampering with odometers, and reselling the cars. Now, the NHTSA says they estimate 500,000 cars are sold every year with fake odometer readings. I guess it would be more than that. There's usual plea bargain. Ghali stuck a plea agreement. The prosecutor said he and his brother did about 690 cars from 06 to 2011, where they tampered with the odometers and rolled them back 69,000 miles on average. And these clowns, hey, they knew somebody who knew something about software. They used handheld electric devices to lower the speedometer. They figured out how to do it with an electronic device, so they didn't even have to buy another speedometer. They just did it electronically. What they did was they bought cars from Florida, Illinois, Maryland, Missouri using fake names and fake dealer names for the selling, had the odometers changed, then resold them in New Jersey and Pennsylvania and got false titled mileage in Pennsylvania. They had them retitled in Pennsylvania. I guess it's easy to get titles in Pennsylvania. So realize there's clowns out there like them that can electronically reset those new speedometers that are all digital electronic readouts. They caught this one guy. Well, you know, it took them years. Look, federal prosecutors, if there's, you know, at least 500,000 of them, there's probably more than that, yeah, that are being rolled back. Good luck in finding them all. You got to just check it out yourself. Make sure there's real paperwork. And if you see it's been retitled somewhere, think about not buying the car. Got some fishy place from Pennsylvania or South Carolina's notorious for giving titles and retitling them, even are stolen or fake odometer reading. So be careful when you're buying a used car, because there's guys like this all over the place. At least he got caught and he's going to jail now. Let's hope it's not one of those rich men jails where they play tennis and have air-conditioned rooms. Let's hope it's a real jail that he's going to. Probably not, though, if he got a plea bargain. Tarek says, my power steering light is on after the brake pads changed and doesn't work right. Got to change my brakes? That happened right away. What could he have done wrong? Well, a lot of things he could have gone wrong, but he probably messed up a sensor or a sensor wire. The sensors are near the brakes and they measure how fast the wheel's spinning. If that system's knocked out, it can screw up your power steering because modern cars, they have electronic power steering. Now, in the old days, it wouldn't have done anything because there were power steering hydraulic pumps that pumped hydraulic high-pressure fluid to the power steering rack to make it push back and forth easier. It wasn't electronically controlled, but modern cars, almost all of them have electronic power steering. So he botched up probably a sensor and they take it back, and if he doesn't know what he's doing, go someplace else and make him pay the repair bill for being stupid and breaking something and not knowing how to fix it after he broke it. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.